Hello friends, today we'll discuss about the Miller indices, again their properties, or we can say that their features. And Miller indices have some rules, and that rules are used for finding the Miller indices. So one by one we'll discuss. So first one, definition of Miller indices. Miller indices is the reciprocal of the intercept made by the plane on crystallographic axis when reduced to its smallest integer, known as a Miller indices. If we see this figure, then it is observed that here x, y and z, these are the crystallographic axes, and here a, b and c, these are the planes. So along x-axis a plane is there, and that plane made the intercept 1a. Similarly, along y-axis the plane is b, and that plane b made the intercept 3b. Similarly, along z-axis plane c made the intercept 2c. Okay, so we'll discuss the rules for finding the Miller indices. So first rule is, take the intercept made by the plane on the crystallographic axis. Means here only we have to take the intercept made by the plane on crystallographic axis. Again, if we see this figure, then it is observed that here only we have to take the intercept. So here along x-axis plane A made the intercept 1A. So only we take 1A intercept along x-axis. Similarly, along y-axis 3B intercept is there, and similarly along z-axis 2c intercept is there. Okay, so first rule is, take the intercept made by the plane on the crystallographic axis, that is a 3b 2c. Okay, now second rule is, take the multipliers of the intercept. Means we have to take only the coefficient of the intercept. Now coefficient of the first intercept is 1. Coefficient of the second intercept is 3. Coefficient of the third intercept is 2. So this is the second rule. Now third rule is, take the reciprocal of the multipliers. Only we have to take the reciprocal of this multiplier. That is 1 upon 1, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 2. Okay. Now fourth rule is, reduce this reciprocal to the smallest integer by LCM. Means here we have to reduce these reciprocals into a smallest integer by taking the LCM. So here the LCM is 6, so multiplied by 6 into 1, that reciprocal, that is 6 into 1 by 1, 6 into 1 by 3, 6 into 1 by 2. So here we get 6, 2 and 3. Okay, now next and last rule, put these numbers in bracket, that is HKL, called as a Miller indices. Hence we can write HKL is equal to 6 2 3. Okay, now in your exam they will ask you, draw the sketches for the plane 100 001. So here it is a simple cube is there. Three axes are there, x, y and z. Now in this figure we have to show only x-axis. So along x-axis this line portion indicates that the plane 1 along the x-axis. Similarly, another plane is 001. Now here we have to show the plane z, means third plane we have to show here in this figure. X is 0, y is 0 and only z plane is there, like this. So similarly, now here 010 plane is there, means only we have to show the y axis or y plane, like this. X is 0, z is 0 and y is equal to 1. Okay, so like this another plane is there. Now next one is the features of Miller indices, means we can say that characteristic or properties of the Miller indices. Now, first rule is, or sorry, first feature of the Miller indices is, Miller indices do not represent a single plane, but it is a set of a parallel equidistant plane. Means, Miller indices never be a single plane. It is a set of a parallel planes. Okay, this is the first feature. Now, second feature is HKL represent all the set of similar plane. For example, if we take the plane 100, so that 100 plane have similar planes like 100, 010 and 001. Okay, so this is the second feature of the Miller indices. Now, third feature is, if HKL are the Miller indices, if we consider HKL be the Miller indices, then for cubic crystal or for a cubic structure, the interplanar distance, here interplanar distance denoted by a letter D. So the for cubic structure, if HKL be the Miller indices, then we can write D of HKL is equal to A divided by root of H square plus K square plus L square. Okay. Now here A indicates lattice constant here. A indicates the lattice constant. Okay. Now fourth feature is, if the intercept of the plane is negative on a certain axis. If sometimes what happen, if the intercept made by the plane is negative, then a bar is placed. Here if we see a bar like this, a bar is placed on a corresponding Miller index. That is, we can write like this, bar 100. Okay. Now next feature is, if the plane is parallel to a certain axis, then the corresponding index is 0. And last feature is, Miller indices write in a bracket and denoted by HKL. Okay. So this is about the features of the Miller indices. After that, we discuss interplanar spacing for a cubic system. Means here we have to derive the formula for the interplanar spacing, particularly for the cubic structure. Okay, so this, consider a cubic unit cell. Now consider a cubic unit cell having lattice constant is A. Means here we have to consider a cubic structure and having lattice constant is A. After that, consider the plane ABC of a cubic crystal having intercept OA, OB, OC. If you see this figure, then it is observed that there are three crystallographic axes, X, Y, Z. Now, the plane along X axis is A, along Y axis is B, and along Z axis the plane is C. Okay, so this plane ABC of a crystal, of cubic crystal having intercept is OA, O into B, again O into C, like this. Okay, after that, let ON is the normal. Now here you can see ON. Now this ON is the normal which is passing through the plane ABC. Now after that, let consider the angle theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 with axial angles. So this ON is perpendicular to this plane ABC. Therefore, we can write this ON is equal to D of HKL. That is, ON is equal to interplanar spacing. That is D. Okay. Or this D indicates that distance between the origin O and plane ABC. Now from the figure, if we see this figure, then it is observed that OA is equal to, now OA intercept is there, which is along the X axis. So this OA intercept is equal to A divided by H. Now here A is nothing but the lattice constant. Okay. And H is nothing but the Miller plane H. Okay. Similarly, along OB, if we consider the intercept OB, then we can write OB is equal to B divided by K. Okay, similarly OC is equal to this OC along Z axis, we can write C divided by L. Okay, now for first direction means we consider this triangle OAN. Okay, now from this triangle theta 1 or cos square theta 1 is equal to what we get? OAN square divided by OA square, means OA is equal to A by H bracket square, like this. Here only we have to put the value of OA. Okay, so by solving this we get D square HKL. Here again we put ON is equal to D, small d. So D square of HKL is equal to what we get? H square. So here we put ON is equal to D. So we get the equation cos square theta 1 is equal to D square HKL into H square divided by A square. Give equation number 1. Now for second direction. Second direction means we consider the second intercept, that is OB. Okay. Now again from this figure, cos square theta 2 is equal to what we get? ON square divided by OB square. OB is equal to B divided by K is there. So OB square means here just we have to take the square of this. So we get again here ON is equal to, we put D. So cos square theta is theta 2 is equal to, we get D square HKL into K square divided by B square. Okay. Now for third direction means for third intercept OC, which is along the Z axis. So here cos square theta 3 is equal to what we get? ON square divided by OC square. Now here OC is equal to C by L is there. So by putting value of OC, we get the final equation cos square theta 3 is equal to D square HKL into L square divided by C square. Okay. Now we know that cos square theta 1 plus cos square theta 2 plus cos square theta 3 is equal to 1. So here in this equation we just put out the value of cos square theta 1, cos square theta 2. Here we have just all these value put in this equation, in this equation. Okay, so we get this equation, that is D square HKL into H square divided by A square plus D square HKL into K square divided by B square plus D square HKL into L square divided by C square is equal to 1, like this. Now throughout this equation the common term, that is D square HKL, is taken as a common. Okay, so remaining term we write in a bracket, that is H square divided by A square plus K square divided by B square plus L square divided by C square is equal to 1. Now only here we have to rearrange this equation like this. One, this term is shifted towards the right hand side, that is 1 divided by D square HKL is equal to H square is divided by A square plus K square divided by B square plus L square divided by C square. And this equation is this is the condition for the orthorhombic structure. Okay, now for cubic structure, here we just put out A is equal to B is equal to C. Means for cubic structure the length, breadth and height all are same, therefore A is equal to B is equal to C. So this equation becomes 1 upon D square HKL is equal to A square plus K square plus L square divided by A square. Okay, or we can write this equation like this: D square HKL is equal to A square divided by A square plus K square plus L square. Or last equation we get, D of HKL is equal to A divided by root of A square plus K square plus L square. And this is the formula of interplanar spacing for a cubic crystal system. Thank you.